Doctors from various medical societies stress that lowering the age of access to vapor products will expose Filipinos, especially the youth, to harmful substances. Dr. Minerva Kalimag, president of the Medical Association, said the vaporized nicotine products regulation bill contradicts the policies to safeguard the well-being of the citizens.
Marami po kasing epekto ng vaping ang nakikita na natin, no, ng mga pasyenteng pumapasok sa ospital dahil din sa mga sakit sa baga. So, ang mga kami po na nasa medical field, no, tingin namin the Vape Bill kontra ito sa pulisiya ng ating bansa, no, to safeguard the well-being of its citizenry, no, lalo na po yung mga kabataan, no.
The Department of Health also expressed support for the call to veto the Vape Bill. However, Health Secretary Francisco Duque III doubts that President Duterte will sign the bill into law.
I am concerned with this vape bill because ang end goal namin is that it will not be enacted into law. Kung mabibito sana, pero hanggang ngayon, ang latest ay wala pang sinusumite ang Congress sa Office of the President.
Okay.
So, yan ang inaantabayanan natin at we will just have to wait what happens next. But I doubt that the President will even sign that law, that bill into law. So, we'll leave it at that, but I am in constant communication. But the goal is really, hopefully, it does not become law.
A bill may become a law even without the President's signature if the President does not sign the bill within 30 days from receipt. It may also become a law without the President's signature if Congress overrides a presidential veto by 2/3 vote. JP Nunez, UNTV, News and Rescue. We serve the people. We give glory to God.